بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. I say reference for the Lord is to protect the enemy, Satan. I bear witness that none deserves to be worshipped except one supreme being alone, one God, who's referred to by many, many different beautiful names. Elohim, Yahweh, Elohim, some say Jesus. The proper name for Almighty God is Allah. اللهم رب هذه الدعوة التامة والصلاة القائمة آتي محمد على صلة وفضلة وقته القائمة المحدودة الذي وعده والله the guardian father the lord of his most perfect call to prayer. Thank you. Grant to Muhammad the means and the exalted steps and raise him unto the glorious place, O God, that you have promised him. We have guests with us, so I want to speak to the guests. We, as Muslims, we believe in only one God. One God. No two gods, no three gods. God is not born. God has no wife. God has no son. One supreme being. I'm saying this for Christian visitors so that they will understand. And this is the religion, the way our people understood religion. Before we were brought to America, the majority of the African Americans that are in the church right now, their foreparents, their ancestors were Muslims. We were kidnapped, we were brought to this country, and just like any child that is kidnapped, it doesn't know its true parents. So likewise as it is for the majority of the African Americans, they don't know who the real parent is in religion, you know. And so I'm saying this to you who are visiting, and this is on the internet. And the world needs to know this truth. The majority of the Muslims that had children, their children were taken into slavery. And the majority of our people that is in the church, the African American, they are children of Muslims. And they must be reunited with their parents. And this is God's mercy. This is God's mercy that the African American can hear what was the religion of his ancestors. Now he can make a choice of the religion that he wants to follow. You know, when you go to the shoe store, you don't just get one pair of shoes. You got choices. Red, brown, black, you know what I mean? Shoes. So likewise it is with religion. You have now the ability to choose your religion. And I'm speaking to the African American who still has not his history. He lost his language. Me, my people. We lost our tradition. We lost our culture. So now Almighty God in his justice, God is just. It's been 400 years since my people knew. And right now they don't know the tradition. We don't know where we're from Mauritania. Are we from Senegal? We don't know. So our good brothers have assisted us, and now we have the Quran, which is the Bible of our ancestors. The majority of our ancestors spoke Arabic in the religion. And the majority of the people on the continent of Africa, the majority of the Africans are Muslims. There are millions of Christians there, but the majority of Muslims. So it's important that I say this to the African Americans because we are the most disenfranchised in all ways, politically, economically, religiously, and etc. So why are you saying it? Because Islam does not accept racism. You cannot bring racism in Islam and make a white God or a black God. You can't do that in Islam. And so what we have is a people who were subjected, their knowledge and traditions were taken from them. And the Islamic religion tells people, do not acculturate a people. When you go somewhere, do not take the excellence of a people's culture away from that.
Islam said that. The Quran said that.
The Quran says, Laqad karamna bani Adam.
That's Arabic.
And it means that Almighty God, all of the children of Adam have been made noble and honorable. This is the Quran. So we are not to see any race inferior to myself. Who you are. Now I'm going to say this to you. Many of you have forgotten it. I'm giving religion of Islam. It can be found in human nature. The Islamic religion. You know? So you may say, well, I don't know what you're talking about. I'm telling you there's no racism in human nature. And I can prove it to you just like that. I don't have to go to college. I don't have to go to the church. All I have to do is have small children who are just now starting to walk, 1 or 2 years old, and every child from every nation, put them together and you will not see racism. Did I make that point clear or did I miss you? You get all the races of children, small, 2 years old, that young, put them together. They know nothing about racism. Please listen to what I'm telling you. So if a child that young knows nothing about racism, then the religion they should have is a religion that's the same way. Okay. It should be a religion that complements their nature. So you find in Islam, there's no white God, there's no black God. Sisters, listen to me. There ain't no male God, there's no male God to put you sisters down. You're not second-class citizens because you come to Islam and because you cover your hair and because you're behind that. No, they have deceived you. When a woman is behind like that, that's dignity. That means that the man understands his responsibility to be out front, to be the provider and the protector. I hope I'm making this clear. So the sisters are behind because you are the most precious. And any trouble that comes to you should meet me first. Allahu Akbar. Yes, this is religion. This is Islamic religion that has purified all of the other religions. Our women are covered up because historically Moses' mother was covered up. Noah's mother was covered up. Jesus' mother was covered up. So these Muslim women have the strength to see that they are following great women who have given birth to prophets. So they want to keep the dignity of the feminine nature. Takbir. This is Islamic religion. This is why she covers up. Because she's saying that Muhammad the prophet has guided this religion so that she, you sisters, who cover your hair, you are helping a man to see you as a mind and not see you as flesh. I hope you could understand what I'm telling you. So you put on that long dress and you force me to see you as a mind. So you women, when you dress like that, you are still preparing me as a man. The first one to teach me was a woman. She fed me, she taught me, she changed my diapers, a woman. And after she gives me birth in my physical body, then the first teacher is also a woman. And so when you sisters cover yourself up, you are helping to educate the world. I thank Allah for you strong sisters that can do that. When this world is tempting you to take all your clothes off, I'm going to say this to you. And I hope you don't get offended. Some of these women in America have on less clothes than the pygmies in Africa. Listen to what I'm telling you. I'm saying this on the internet because I'm trying to shock this country back to its senses. If you're going to point to a pygmy in Africa and call them a savage because they got on half clothes, then what do you call a woman in America that got on less clothes? You understand what I'm telling you? So the savagery is not based on a nation. The savagery is based on morals or immorality. And you sisters are the best one that can turn a country around. Most people are not going to listen to me. I'm a male. They'll challenge me. But when you get an intelligent woman who respects God
and she starts to speak out in morality, all the men listen. I'm telling you, you don't know this. I'm telling you the truth. Why? Because that's mama talking. Every woman is your mother. My white mother. Yeah, this is Islam, man. And some of us men, don't judge the religion by a bunch of us. Some of us are silly. You judge a religion by its character. Same way with Christianity. Don't judge Christian religion by some Christian you see on the street. He may be falling down sloppy drunk. That's not Christianity. So don't judge Islam by any other standard. You'll see. Yeah. Now, I want to say this. I want to thank many of you who have helped us with the roof. You see them, they're repairing the roof. It cost us $44,000. And it's going to cost a little bit more because there's more damage that they found that we didn't know anything about. So we thank all of you who sent donations in. We thank Allah, may Allah accept your donation and give you great reward. And some of you are too poor to give anything, but your intention was to give, and Allah will give you the reward as though you had the money. This is this religion. If you do one thing right in this religion, you get a minimum of 10 rewards from God. If you intend to do something wrong and you do not do the wrong, you get a reward from God. Can you imagine that? Yes. And why is that? Because the human being is not born in sin. Allahu Akbar. Some of you have heard this before. Let me say this to my Christian friends, our visitors. When that baby or you were inside of your mother's womb, you were not committing sin. You wasn't smoking no reefer in there. You wasn't drinking no wine in there. You understand what I'm trying to tell you? Okay, so when you come out of your mother's womb, you're still not drinking or smoking. Am I right or wrong? It's long after you have been out of the womb, then some fool who's 21 or 17 who wants a slave will give you a reefer or give you alcohol. And now you have committed sin because you have followed a sinner. But it take a long time. I see a little baby right there jumping in his daddy's arms, right in front of him. That little kid right there, he ain't no sinner. He don't even know what sin is. You say, what is sin? He'll look at you. Yes, with a cookie. He'll say, yeah. Don't know what sin is? Why not? How come he doesn't know what sin is? Because no woman can produce a sinner. Good God Almighty. Look, if I was a woman, I'd fly off. I said, is that the Islamic religion? Is that what Prophet Muhammad said? That me, a woman, I cannot produce a sinner? Oh, Prophet Muhammad and the Quran said even more than that. You know what it said? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the Quran it said that it was Satan who suggested that the man and the woman fall down together. Allahu Akbar. In the Quran, it does not insult the woman's intelligence in telling her that a snake suggested that she do something wrong. Allahu Akbar. This is being taught right now all around the world. So Muhammad the Prophet had to come as a liberator for the women. This is the women's liberation movement. It started in the Quran. Allahu Akbar. And in the Muslim religion, it says that the man and the woman were deceived together. Sisters, it does not blame you. Allahu Akbar. I don't know if you understand what I'm telling you. Though some of us have been beat upside the head with wrong knowledge for so long, when the truth comes, we still staggering from the blows. I'm serious. I had women here in the mosque. They came and visited us. And I told them, in our religion, it says that you women, you don't create a child, you don't have a child created in sin. This is a sister. She was pregnant. And she said, my baby is being created in sin. She told me to my face in this mosque. Now that shows you how damaged people are. So I asked her, I said, what sin is the child committing in there? She couldn't say nothing. She said, but he's still a sinner. Good God Almighty. So don't tell me we don't need Islam. We need Islam terribly bad. You're not going to have any sustained progress with these things lurking in the back of your subconscious mind. You wonder why a man will hit a woman. You wonder why he'll beat a woman. You wonder why he will disdain a woman. You wonder why he makes her a prostitute. It's because he was told as a little bitty child that his mother was the first one that brought a whole of humanity down. So when he can't face the world and he has her, he takes that frustration out on her, because you have become the Eve's misinterpreted story in his subconscious mind. Now you bring me a psychologist. You bring me the Pope and have him challenge and show me where I'm wrong. He ain't gonna come there. Let me go to Rome, take me anywhere. Y'all go with me, take a video camera, and I guarantee you, he ain't gonna be able to answer. These are things that are lurking, and they're sociological problems in nations. You should thank God for this insight from Muhammad the Prophet. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yeah. I don't ever think I remember where Jesus said that you were a sinner. Somebody need to show me that in the Bible where Jesus said you created in sin. Did you hear what I just said to you? Somebody show me in the Bible what Jesus said, you are created in sin. I want to see what Jesus said. Don't be putting words in the prophet's mouth. That's you saying that. That's not Christ Jesus. You know why I tell you that? Because Christ Jesus was a Muslim. Oh, I know, I'm shaking a bunch of people up. I know this. He was a Muslim. Moses was a Muslim. Noah was a Muslim. Abraham was a Muslim. All of those prophets were Muslim. And I challenge you to show me in their text where Moses said, I'm a Jew. It ain't in there. Where Jesus said, I'm a Christian. It is not in there. The Quran is the only sacred text on the face of the earth that gives you the name of the religion of the prophets. Every single one of them.